Racing to the 2022 Kentucky Oaks, and this time we go to Churchill Downs beneath the Twin Spires, a 14-horse field lined up for Friday. It is a grade one race, 14 fillies, three-year-olds, and they will go 9 furlongs, a mile and an eighth, to determine the best three-year-old filly in the United States. Of course, Saturday is going to be the Kentucky Derby. We've already got a preview up of that 20-horse field. You can watch that at the link above. Let's start off at a look at this field at the rail. We've got Secret Oath, goes for the coach, drew the rail. She took on the boys the last time, running third at Oaklawn Park. Nostalgic, Bill Mott has a filly peaking here. Back-to-back wins, including the Gazelle Stakes at Aqueduct. Hidden Connection, lost to Echo Zulu the last time out by just a head, was gaining at the wire. She has a big win at Churchill Downs as a two-year-old. Nest won the Ashland Stakes for Todd Pletcher. He won the Oaks last year with Malathot, tries to make it two in a row with Nest. Goddess of Fire, another one trained by Todd Pletcher, second place out the last time out to Kathleen O. Uguri wired the field at Oaklawn. That one was a little bit of a surprise that day. She's going to be on the lead or near the lead in the Kentucky Oaks. Echo Zulu, undefeated, 5-for-5. Steve Asmussen trains the 5-to-2 morning line favorite. Venti Valentine, the filly from New York, has speed. Desert Dawn, a big win in the last race at 14-to-1 out west at Santa Anita. And then Kathleen O, the undefeated Gulfstream Park Oaks winner. She comes in for trainer Shug McGahey. Cocktail Moments, Ken McPeak with a long shot filly in this one. Candy Raid, the Cajuns come calling as long shots. And then Shamama, an undefeated UAE Oaks winner. She's 4-for-4. She's by the Speedy Munnings. 9 furlongs is going to be the big question for Shamama. And Turner Luce, the upset winner in Louisiana. Brad Cox trained, but she drew the 14th post position. That's going to be a tough one to win out of. All the points leaders are here. Kathleen O, Echo Zulu, Nest, and Uguri all won their final preps. They're going to come in this one along with Desert Dawn and Nostalgic and try to win this field, a competitive field, 3 undefeated fillies, and the grade one winner is Echo Zulu. She won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies last year to close out a two-year-old champion campaign. She is by Speedy Sire and, of course, Echo Zulu, 5-for-5. Multiple stakes winners, we've got Kathleen O, Secret Oath, and Shamama for Todd Pletcher. Those three are going to do battle against the two-year-old champion in Echo Zulu. Of course, Secret Oath, last time out, faced the boys at Oaklawn Park. Now, the undefeateds, Echo Zulu, 5-for-5. Shahama, 4-for-4. And Kathleen O is also 4-for-4. She ships up a couple of back-to-back wins at Gulfstream Park, including a big win by almost 8 lengths on January the 1st. Secret Oath goes for Dwayne Lucas, couple of dominant wins at Oaklawn Park. And of course, she's going to try to get back on the win streak here. Going to take on the best of this generation in Nest, along with Kathleen O and Echo Zulu. Hidden Connection, been training well. Back-to-back, nice workouts after the loss to Echo Zulu. First race of the year seemed to be just a prep. She really picked it up in her second race this year. Another one at longer than 10-to-1 odds, definitely worth taking a look at. Let's take a look at this pace of the race for the Kentucky Oaks. Going to look at where they're going to be, where the arrow is here. That's right around the back stretch, middle down the back stretch, 4 furlongs into the race. I think Echo Zulu is going to be in front. Hidden Connection and Venti Valentine are going to be the closest pursuers. And of course, Echo Zulu has been running on the lead in her last couple of races. Now, when we get to the turn, the 6-to-7 furlong mark, I see Echo Zulu and Hidden Connection. One of those two is the most likely leaders. And then we're going to have some fillies kind of zone in on them. We've got Nest, Nostalgic, Venti Valentine, and Kathleen O. Those are going to make that first wave. And of course, how they determine how long Echo Zulu has to fight against some of those oncoming rush could determine if the speed is going to hold up in this race. And when you got the closers, if you want to take a look at some closers that could make a move down the lane for the exacta or maybe win that race, you've got Nostalgic, Secret Oath, and Desert Dawn. Those are the horses that are going to be coming from the rear of the pack, starting to make their move at that going into that second turn right around the 6 furlong mark just behind Nest, and also with Kathleen O making the move at that time. So definitely we've got a little bit of speed, we've got some horses pressing, and some horses coming from behind in this year's Kentucky Oaks. I think the three horses most improving are Kathleen O, Nostalgic, and Nest. Kathleen O really hasn't seen the bottom of her in her last couple of races, won really easily. Nostalgic, back-to-back wins for Bill Mott. Big win after being kind of trapped in the at the rail in the Gazelle. Got some running room late and drew away. I think she's going to like the 9 furlong distance. And then Nest, by Curlin, trained by Todd Pletcher. Big win at Tampa Bay. Back-to-back wins to start off her three-year-old season. Been training forwardly, and 9 furlongs is definitely going to be a good distance for Nest in the 2022 Kentucky Oaks. Now, the top contenders on the morning line, Nest, Kathleen O, Nostalgic, Venti Valentine, Hidden Connection, and Secret Oath. That's who I think are going to be the main contenders for the Oaks. A mix of some speed, then some good stamina runners, and Nest and Nostalgic. And Venti Valentine, a big race the last time, she can improve here at 9 furlongs with a softer pace. The morning line is out. Secret Oath is 6-1. Nest is 5-2. You've got Kathleen O at 7-2, and Echo Zulu at 4-1. Uguri is 30-1, and Turner Loose 20-1 on the outside. Secret Oath could be a little bit less than that. I think Nest is going to be a little bit more, and Echo Zulu probably a little less, closer to 3-1, I think, being the undefeated champion. My selection for the 2022 Kentucky Oaks is going to be Venti Valentine. Going to go with a little bit of a upset here. Venti Valentine dueled with Nostalgic the last time. Ran on a fast surface. I think she can improve her third out of the year. She ran against Nest as a two-year-old. That extra furlong is going to be a little bit of a challenge, but I think the pace could be a little bit soft. She can come just off the pace this time. Exactas, Venti Valentine over Nest, Nostalgic, Kathleen O, and Hidden Connection. If you're the type that likes to play a long shot and are looking for a little bit of a longer price in your doubles and pick threes, then look no further than Nostalgic. She's got back-to-back wins, a strong pedigree, improving speed figures, a lot to like with Nest if you want to take a little bit of a long shot. Echo Zulu, you know, she won that first race of her three-year-old campaign, a lot of speed last year. She's got to prove she can get the 9 furlongs. She's a little bit smaller of a filly. I do think the rain will help her. It might rain on Friday, and that could definitely help Echo Zulu. Who do you like in the Kentucky Oaks? Leave a comment. Remember, support the channel. Hit the like button, share, and hit that thanks button as we've got a preview up of the 2022 Kentucky Derby. Leave your comment. Who do you like on the Kentucky Oaks? Do you think Ness can win? Maybe Echo Zulu. How about Secret Oath? Are they the top contenders for this year's Kentucky Oaks? A very competitive field, 3 undefeated fillies, and of course, it's all going to get underway the first Friday in May, Friday afternoon from Churchill Downs. The 2022 Kentucky Oaks, Nest, Kathleen O, Secret Oath, and Nostalgic doing battle underneath the Twin Spires.